Welcome to State of Play on South First, a show that tells you all about South, especially its politics. On this episode of State of Play, I would like to answer a question that everybody in Telangana is wondering about. Why does Telangana Chief Minister Revanth Reddy do what he does? Welcome to the show. Whether it is singing praises of Narendra Modi, calling him a brother, or signing an MOU with Adani firm, Adani, who has turned into a tool for the Congress to attack the incumbent BJP-led front at the centre. Revanth Reddy keeps his party workers, baiters and rivals guessing alike. The latest to this addition is his idea to constitute Hydra, a new agency that is vested with the responsibility of identifying encroached lands, clearing them and reclaiming government lands. Now, why has Revanth Reddy initiated this entire process is the question. It seems Telangana Chief Minister Revanth Reddy is under a lot of pressure. The last few months that he has been the Chief Minister, there really seems to be nothing that he can claim his own, his legacy, or something that has left a mark. And this has put him under tremendous pressure. Why? Because his predecessors, whether it is the Chief Minister right before him, BRS's chief and the first chief minister of Telangana, K. Chandrasekhar Rao, or the erstwhile chief ministers of Andhra Pradesh, United Andhra Pradesh, Chandrababu Naidu, who Revanth Reddy thinks of as a political guru, or his own party's renowned popular leader from the Telugu state, Y.S. Rajasekhar Reddy. All these three chief ministers have been strongman chief ministers with legacies of their own. In this lineup is Revanth Reddy, who you cannot really blame because he's never been part of a cabinet. The first time he's part of a cabinet, he's directly become the chief minister. Revanth Reddy doesn't really have a stature when people would compare him to his predecessors. That seems to be the issue. It all started apparently a few weeks ago when a set of well-wishers, some 15-20 people, decided to meet Revanth Reddy and speak to him about his entire administration. In the course of the conversation, something interesting came up. The conversation veered into this very question: what is it that Revanth Reddy has done as Chief Minister that the people of Telangana should remember him for? The questions that were raised is whether Revanth Reddy has the kind of stature that the other chief ministers, whether it is of Telangana or the erstwhile Andhra Pradesh, have had. Luckily for Revanth Reddy, in this group of well-wishers was also an environmentalist who pointed out that Hyderabad used to be known as the city of lakes, some 185 lakes, and today the city cannot really boast of great lakes. Some of them have completely dried up, there are others that have been turned into sewage tanks, and several of them have been encroached upon. In fact, earlier a report in the Times of India said that more than 60% of Hyderabad lake area has shrunk in the last 4 decades. That, it seems, got Revanth Reddy thinking. If he were to come up with an idea to reclaim this land, Revanth Reddy would be doing something that none of his predecessors have done. Consecutive governments before Revanth Reddy's have either neglected, ignored, or at some level have been complicit in the encroachment of government lands. With a movement to reclaim these government lands, Revanth Reddy could actually start building the momentum to build a legacy. Not the one to let go of this opportunity, Revanth Reddy, it seems, pounced on this very idea and ended up constituting Hydra in July. In less than 1 month, Hydra has hit the headlines, especially when it went after properties owned by or linked two powerful people, politicians, celebrities, businessmen. In fact, Hydra hit the headlines prominently when it went after a convention center that belongs to Telugu superstar Nagarjuna. Initially, a lot of baiters of Revanth Reddy insisted that this perhaps is a way to indulge in vindictive politics, to target people that the chief minister does not like personally, or perhaps is a ploy to put pressure on the real estate lobby. However, the target in this entire scenario seems to be completely something else. As if to shut up critics who insisted that Hydra's actions were some sort of politically vindictive behavior, the agency listed properties belonging to politicians or linked to politicians and their kin, cutting across party lines: Congress, BRS, BJP. In fact, one such property was leased by Congress's senior leader and a former union minister, Pallam Raju's brother. If perception was the point of this entire exercise, then Revanth Reddy hit the bullseye when Hydra went after his own brother's property. Does this legacy building exercise come with some kind of a political cost? Well, several baiters, rivals of Revanth Reddy, insisted that his shenanigans or antics were irking the central leadership of the Congress, and he received a rap on the knuckles. In fact, a lot of leaders within the Congress in Telangana insisted that the high command has rebuked Revanth Reddy for a series of things, whether it is the Narendra Modi incident, Adani incident, or now the Hydra incident. But party insiders suggest that this perhaps is not the reality. It's not as if Revanth Reddy's actions are going unnoticed. In fact, Congress's General Secretary of Organization, KC Venugopal, is said to have held a meeting with Revanth Reddy where he asked him if the Chief Minister of Telangana is unnecessarily making more enemies than necessary by going after the rich, the influential and the powerful. Revanth Reddy has already seen the kind of support he is getting from different sections of people. See, in India, a poor person's house gets demolished all the time under the garb of encroachment clearance. It is very rare that you see the rich, the powerful, the influential go and complain in public that the government is going after their property. Although following Hydra's actions, GHMC, the municipal corporation in Hyderabad, went after demolishing homes belonging to poor and middle class families and received quite a bit of criticism for it. Largely, Revanth Reddy has gained popularity and support from various sections of people who have appreciated him for doing what none of the leaders before him have done, going after the rich, the influential, and the powerful as law mandates. And that, it seems, was his answer to KC Venugopal, that due process has been followed. In fact, when a property linked to Pallam Raju's brother was raised within the Congress quarters, Sonia Gandhi is said to have asked Revanth Reddy just one question: was due process followed? Despite the criticism that Hydra is facing about not issuing notices in time or not allowing time for people to respond to notices, Revanth Reddy is said to have insisted that due process has been followed and all caution has been taken to ensure that this move only brings good publicity to not just him but the party. In fact, it almost seems like every time a structure is pulled down or every square foot of land is reclaimed by Hydra, Revanth Reddy inches one step closer to his milestone of building a legacy. There is another reason why the Congress is not going after Revanth Reddy the way his rivals would want the party to go after him. The Congress is in power in only three states. Telangana is a very important state for the Congress, not just for relevance, but also to fund its elections. For the Congress, Revanth Reddy in Telangana is just like D.K. Shivkumar in Karnataka. They are both dependable leaders. Congress's General Secretary K.C. Venugopal may also have a personal stake in backing Revanth Reddy. Considering how close K.C. Venugopal is to Rahul Gandhi, the stance that K.C. Venugopal takes with respect to leaders is pretty much the stance that Rahul Gandhi is on board for. For K.C. Venugopal, Revanth Reddy is very important as a leader who could back him when he would like to propose his name to be considered by the party as Chief Minister candidate for Kerala when the state goes to assembly elections. The situation could have been very, very different if the Congress had gotten more than 110 seats in the Lok Sabha elections. But for now, the Congress cannot afford to have any instability in any of the states that it is in power in. Telangana, for example, is one such state where the Congress cannot afford to even give a hint of rebuking the Chief Minister. Within the party, there are several rivals and baiters for Revanth Reddy who are lying in wait for their opportunity to rise in dissent, and that is something that the Congress cannot afford. So if you're wondering why Revanth Reddy, despite all of the things he does, continues to enjoy the support of the Congress, this is why. Thank you so much for watching.